The Gravity 12 Hour is fast becoming one of Australia's premier enduro mountain bike events. Rosewhite, the small country town in northeast Victoria, once again played host to the 8th edition of the race.
The event's what's called in mountain biking circles an enduro event, so riders can compete solo over a 12-hour period, and the rider with the most laps becomes the winner. But riders can also compete in teams of pairs, male pairs, mixed pairs or female pairs, and then also in teams of three or four or six.
It's a 13-kilometre circuit. It's single track predominantly. There's probably about a kilometre of fire road. So it's a pretty special mountain bike race with so much single track in it. And basically people racing in teams predominantly. We've got a few solo riders. And they come out here, have a bit of fun and ride around the circuit for 12 hours.
The atmosphere of the event is, it's how we like it. It's a family, it's camping. We have the kids race here, so we encourage people that are racing, the families that are racing, for the kids to bring their little bikes out, and we cut them in a little course up behind the back of the venue, and they have a little kids race and they love that. So yeah, I'm a family man, so I like my events to be family orientated as well.
And then we've also got some guys sort of the end of their 60s that are riding around today, and they're just as excited. And I think, you know, the Van der Ploeg family is a great example there. You've got four boys riding today, and Jerry, their dad, who's in his 60s.
I think mountain biking has a huge fun element. There's nothing like riding a bit of single track on a downhill descent, swerving around corners and so on. Like, there's an excitement there that you can't get on a road bike.
Jerry's son Paul is the under 23 national mountain bike champion, and is a keen supporter of the Gravity 12 Hour.
I had a really good start of the year when I was doing the Australian season, then went over to the World Cups and had a bit of up and downs, like some good races but some disasters where I dislocate my shoulder or do something like that.
As expected, Paul clocked the fastest time for the day on the 13-kilometre circuit in 31 minutes and 44 seconds.
Yeah, the course was... look, it's got a little bit better, but it's a little bit boggy. It's certainly not as dry and dusty as it has been in previous years. We've sort of come here to expect the unexpected. We've had anything from 36 degrees to alpine storms coming through at, you know, 2:30 in the morning, and you just never know what you're going to get when you come to the Gravity 12 Hour.
It's pretty unique. I mean, we've got some of the country's fastest young riders here today, and we've also got some of the country's slowest old riders. So that's a pretty unique thing about mountain biking, is that you get a mix of all levels. And I think that's a pretty special part of the sport, that you do get to come along and see how far behind you are the best riders, and challenge yourself.
Yeah, I suppose it's a bit like interval training, because you go just full gas as long as you can for a lap, and then you get a rest and then you go out again. It's really good training coming into the Olympic National Series format.
A bit depressing looking at their times and then looking at your own times, but they've got the value of youth, I suppose.
With the majority of Australia's cycling focus centred around road racing, it appears that mountain bike racing is starting to bridge the gap in popularity among the recreational riders.
Yeah, mountain biking's, look, it's really social. I mean, I've actually never done any road racing myself, but, you know, quite a few of the other members here have. I guess our club's probably more a social club. There's a little bit of an element of racing about it. We've got a couple of elite, you know, type athletes in the club. Luke Fetch and, you know, Craig Borum, just to mention a few. Look, the terrain down in the Mornington Peninsula, it's just, it's perfect for it, you know. It's really perfect for mountain biking.
Yeah, I'm actually finding both are growing equally, you know. These events, people are turning up all the time, the numbers are increasing, but I'm going to the criteriums and the road races and the numbers are growing as well. So it's just all good for cycling. It's growing nicely in just about every category.
Well, I think that's probably what separates us down the peninsula, because we're fortunate that we got a school down there, Germana Secondary College, which one of the teachers is one of the members of the club, and he's really pushed it home with the school and the education department to get cycling as part of their curriculum. And so there's a bit of a junior development aspect on the peninsula, and also a lot of the kids, as I say, with, you know, there's I think we've got three or four teams here today of, you know, juniors, like the, you know, boys and girls sort of below 16.
Look, the product sponsors are fantastic, and we've had a really long association with Hammer Nutrition and Ground Effect and Kona. Bicycle Superstore's come in the last couple of years and just been an awesome support for us, not only for this event, but for Terra Australis as well. And look, they're absolutely crucial, and it really adds to the event too. You know, the guys know they can bring their bikes here and know they're going to get looked after with the great mechanics that Bicycle Superstore have brought along. And you know, the events couldn't run without them. And you know, I think I speak for everyone in the industry that we do really value the support that the product sponsors provide.
Although event sponsorship is growing stronger, recent cutbacks in funding for the high performance program have made things a little bit more difficult for Australia's rising mountain bike stars.
I don't know how that's going to pan out over the next few years. I think that as we've seen with our road riders, they've got a higher and higher profile. So if the same thing happens in mountain biking, then it'll come back.
Last year, Paul had plans to have a number of trips overseas. It all fell in the hole in the end because of the lack of support. So it has made a bit of an impact.
Well, initially, yeah, it did. Like, I struggled to get a bit of funding and support, but then I signed with the Felt Otstal Exponic World Cup team, so they were a really good support over there, and when I was over in Germany, they just looked after me the whole time, so it was perfect.
We've had some really solid results on the world stage over the last 12 months, and I think those results should hopefully see some funds flow back into the sport from Cycling Australia, and you know, it has been a great pathway. I mean, you look at Cadel Evans. He started his cycling career on a mountain bike, and there's plenty of other guys getting around on their mountain bikes now who've got long cycling careers in front of them. So yeah, I think it's important that the sport does get that that funding support.
Paul's one of those kids. When he was young, he just loved riding his BMX. He used to build big jumps at home, spent hours building them and then jumping them. He loves riding a bike, and the mountain biking suits him because of that fun element. He doesn't mind road riding, but whether he would ever make the switch, I don't know.
Yeah, obviously whenever I do testing and things, they're like, oh, you could be a good time trialist or track rider or road rider, but sort of I love mountain biking, so I'm not about to change anytime soon.
As the sun fell over Rose White, it was time for riders to flick on the lights for the final hours leading up to the 9 o'clock finish. Matt Zagoski took out the solo men's event, completing 16 laps of the course in 12 grueling hours of riding.
A bit sore, pretty stoked though. Didn't think, came here today with not thinking I'd achieve something like that, so I'm very happy, yeah. Endurance events are just huge at the moment. Great to see hundreds of people here today. It's really going off, it's good.
The Gravity 12 Hour will be back bigger and better in 2011. This is Dan Jones for Cycling Central.